Morning. What a beautiful day it is today, Friday, the 9th of February 2018. We give God all the praise. Have you ever wondered how to gain access to God? Have you been in a place where you wondered, it's like you need to get so through to God and you just do not know how and which protocol to observe and all of that? Let's stay glued to this quiet time because we shall be learning how to gain access into the Holy of Holies in the name of Jesus. Share this quiet time right away on your timeline. Let it be a blessing to many people out there, even after the broadcast is over. Come back, click on that same share button and start inviting all your friends to join in. As we speak in tongues, we charge ourselves and build ourselves up in our most holy faith, and we worship and praise the Most High God. We made it to Friday because of His mercies that are brand new towards us every blessed day. We are here because of the Almighty God, whose hand has kept us, protected us, and delivered us through it all. We give God praise. Yes, Lord, you are indescribable. Yes, Father, I give you glory, I give you all the praise this morning. Indiri bosi ket erebe shu bahare kandiri bosi atore bahari adara barore. Ikandore bosi at erebe kembarot ariandara bara. Yarosi ket erebo haru at erebe kebaro andara bi at ereme. I andore bosi ket erehari maria dara bise eket ariyo tore bora. Indiri boshe bo aria so bahare akot areboshi ere adiri bedo. Iva roya diri bosi kendere bora, rea diri beket are bosho tare bere. Ima ro diri bekoti aro basi aro ke aro shi adore. I anduri moza hi yako ere morde. Iki diri bosi a diri boshi e kenduri bore. Ma out iri bora si e ke tihere maria diri bore. Mi ako tere boshi haro tiri boket are bore. Mahari adiri bosi ereke tere boshi hari adiri bara. Ike diri bose, yes Lord, your name is Yahweh. And I give you all the glory. You are the I am that I am. The Almighty God, the indescribable God. Lord, I bless your most holy name this morning, and I take time out to say thank you for your love. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for not giving up on the cross for me, for going all the way and dying and shedding your blood for me, that I may gain access to our Heavenly Father. That I may be reconciled to our Heavenly Father. I give you praise and I thank you. Lord, as we look into your word, we pray that you open our eyes, let the scales fall, that we may behold the wonderful things that you have in store for us. Holy Spirit, fill us one more time. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. The God of all flesh, it is the God and His name is Yahweh. His name is Yahweh. Yahweh. He's my God and His name is Yahweh. His name is Yahweh. Yahweh. My God and His name is Yahweh. His name is Yahweh. He's my God and His name is Yahweh. His name is Yahweh. Yahweh. And His name is Yahweh. My God and His name is Yahweh. Yahweh. And His name is Yahweh. His name is Yahweh. His name is Yahweh. It doesn't matter what you go through, God remains God. He is unshaken, unmovable by our situations and circumstances. Therefore, you must be determined to be happy today. It's a beautiful day and you are going to rejoice in it because God is still God. Hallelujah. Good morning, one more time. My name is Pastor Mrs. Engineer June Bright and I bring you the quiet time. Written by my father, Bishop Dagiwa Mills, on behalf of my husband, my pastor, my king, my lord, my covering, the one and only living mandate, Reverend Peter Bright Sr. I am most privileged to have him as my husband, my producer, and the visionary behind this program, Quiet Time with Mrs. Mandate. And above all, I'm most blessed to be able to help him fulfill the mandate upon his life. I thank God so much for him. Today, we are going to learn the secret to gaining access to God, free access to God. Well, it was not really free because someone had to pay the price. And that someone, your guess is as good as my Jesus Christ. He shed his blood for us. So we are going to have a deeper understanding of it then so that we can be able to come boldly unto the throne of grace. Hebrews 4:16, let us come boldly unto the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Our Heavenly Father wants us to come boldly, not timidly. Why can we come boldly? We can come boldly because Jesus shed his blood. The blood of Jesus gives us access to our Heavenly Father. So much access. Turn your Bibles with me to Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 10. Let's read from verse 10 to 21. It reads, King James Version, by the which we are sanctified through the offering of the blood, the body of Jesus Christ, once for all. I take that again. By the which will, we are sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ, once for all. And every priest standeth daily ministering, and offering oftentimes the same sacrifices, which can never take away sins. Let me explain that before we go deeper. You know, before Jesus came, there have been priests, after the Levites, who are priests that stand before God ministering, and they minister daily. Bible is telling us that this daily ministration and offering, the sacrifices that they make to never take away our sins. They were offering the blood of goats, blood of lamb and all of that, and turtle dove based on peace offerings and burnt sacrifices, peace offerings and all of that. But all of that could not take away our sins. It could only atone for them for a season, and when you sin again, you have to go back and make another sacrifice. But guess what? You and I do not have to go all over the place looking for all of these animals to kill, because Jesus has paid the price once and for all. He's paid the price over 2,000 years ago, and the blood of Jesus is still viable today. No matter what we do, the blood of Jesus, once we come to the point where we acknowledge that we have sinned and plead and ask God for forgiveness and ask Him to wash us with the precious blood of Jesus. That's 1 John 1:8 and 9. We are washed. The blood of Jesus does not finish. It is a fountain that does not dry. How beautiful that is. So we can never come to the point where we have sinned so much that the blood of Jesus has finished. Or the blood of Jesus for, let's say for me, is measured. And so it's like if I have finished using it, it's finished. No, the blood of Jesus is not measured. But nonetheless, that does not give us It doesn't mean that we should continue in sin. Paul says that do we continue in sin that grace may abound? No. We do not continue in sin because the blood of Jesus is available. But that is the blood of Jesus takes away our guilt, our shame, and gives us access to God. So I continue to read verse 12. But this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down on the right hand of God. How cool is that? After he sacrificed for sins, offered only one sacrifice, one serious sacrifice, his very life. What manner of love is this that a man should lay down his life for a friend? That is why when you and I do not tell others about Jesus, about the fact that Jesus paid the price and died for them, it's so terrible. And to you watching, Jesus has paid the price. There is no amount of sin, amount of guilt, shame that you are feeling that the blood of Jesus cannot wipe away and make you have access to God. He sacrificed it, his very, very life, once. That sacrifice is so powerful and it's so viable today. So, but this man, that is Jesus Christ, after he had offered one sacrifice for sins forever, sat down at the right hand of God. And Hebrews 12 tells us that he's seated at the right hand of God making intercessions for you and I. 13, from henceforth expecting till his enemies be made his footstool. For by one offering he hath perfected forever them that are sanctified. These are the cool things about the blood of Jesus. He's perfected us. The blood of Jesus makes us perfect and sanctifies us. Because God is holy, and he that comes to him must come and worship him in spirit and in holiness. So the blood of Jesus gives us that holiness, that perfection, and that enables us to approach our Heavenly Father without fear, without any shyness, without any timidness. When we come before our Heavenly Father, we are supposed to be real and plain. And the blood of Jesus gives us that boldness and that comfort and that relaxation in order to be open and gain access to our Heavenly Father. Wherefore the Holy Spirit, verse 15, also is a witness to us. For after that he had said before, this is the covenant that I will make with them after those days. This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, saith the Lord. And I will put my laws into their hearts, and in their minds will I write them. and their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. The blood of Jesus gets us into a covenant with the Most High God, with the Almighty God, with the Yahweh, the I am that I am. The I am that I am sort of gives me the feeling of who is who. It's like my Heavenly Father is bragging. Who is who? The fact is, we cannot limit him. The reason for all of these names, Jehovah Elion, Jehovah Chicken, Jehovah Sabwa, Jehovah Shalom, Elion, all of those names came about as a result of God, people's revelations about God, the patriarchs. As they walked with God, they realized that, wow, God is Jehovah Rapha, the Lord my healer. He is the Lord my righteousness. Jehovah Chicken, the Lord who sanctified. He is my God who is mighty in battle. All those are as a result of walking with God and coming to the point where we have a deep revelation of, wow, he is my provider, he is my healer, and all, he is my peace and all of that. But God, when he was introducing himself to Moses, when Moses said that, who will I say to Pharaoh that sent me? He said, tell him, I am that I am. I am that I am. He is so powerful. He is so powerful. There is none that can be compared to our Heavenly Father. He is simply indescribable. He is that I am that I am. The Almighty God. Almighty. Almighty, which means all might belongs to him. Almighty, all power belongs to him. He is the I am that I am. He is in a class of his own. So there is actually no word that can just describe him just like that. That is why he is the I am that I am. I am the who is who. I created the whole world, this universe that that we only understand, and in fact scientists have just discovered that there are other universes. God is just almighty. And the blood of Jesus gives us a covenant with such a powerful, almighty God. The blood of Jesus gets us into a covenant with him. A covenant with him, an agreement with a powerful being like that, an agreement that I will take care of you, an agreement that I will lead you, an agreement that I will guide you, I will protect you, I will deliver you. That is the God we serve. And the blood of Jesus has made us, gotten that agreement for us, that covenant for us. And guess what? It doesn't end there. Verse 16 says that, and then the Lord says that, I will put my law in their hearts, and in their minds will I write them. 17, and their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. The blood of Jesus cleanses us and washes us clean, makes us white as wool. It does not matter the number of abortions you committed. It does not matter if you've been a homosexual. It doesn't matter if you've been a lesbian. The blood of Jesus is able to wash you clean. And the reason why you can come boldly onto his throne of grace is because he says that your sins and your iniquities will I remember no more. Will I remember no more. The slate is clean. Once you've confessed your sins and asked for the blood of Jesus to wash you clean, our Heavenly Father does not remember your sins anymore. He throws it into the sea of forgetfulness. He does not remember it anymore. Therefore, there is no more shame. There is no more guilt. You know, sometimes we find it difficult to forgive ourselves for the things we've done. But guess what? I came to tell you, Our Heavenly Father says, your sins and your iniquities do I remember no more. It is time to forgive yourself. Let it go. Let the shame go away. He doesn't remember it anymore. Verse 18, now where remission of these is, there is no more offering of sin. There's no more offering of sin. Jesus has already offered himself for our sins. So we don't need to offer anything anymore for our sins. We do not need to go looking for sacrificing animals for our sins to be washed. We do not need to. If any pastor tells you you must give an offering, he is lying to you. You must pay some amount of money for your sins to be washed, or he needs to bathe you for your sins to be washed. That is a lie from the pit of hell. All you need to do is to ask God to forgive you of your sins. And of course, God tells us in James that if you can confess your sins to one another. If you so wish to do that, that's okay. But you must find the right person to do that, your pastor, most preferable. But your pastor cannot wash you with, bathe you for your sins to be forgiven. Only the blood of Jesus. He can lead you to confess it, and that is okay. The blood of Jesus has already offered, it's already been offered for our sins. Verse 19, having therefore, brethren, boldness to enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Before Jesus shed his blood, there was a veil that separated the Holy of Holies from the porch and the outer court. And when Jesus died on the cross, the veil was torn apart. And Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, gave us access into the Holy of Holies. Into the Holy of Holies. So now we have access to where God is. That's why he said we should come boldly onto the throne of grace. Boldly, we have access to, in quotes, God's bedroom. To enter someone's bedroom, it means you are seriously close to the person. And that is what the blood of Jesus has done for you and I. It gives us access to God, into his very innermost chamber, the Holy of Holies, because the blood of Jesus makes us holy, makes us perfect, and gives us this access. So we come boldly unto our Father. Boldly to our Father. When your son or daughter knocks on your bedroom door, he comes in boldly because he knows he's coming to his father or to his mother. He comes boldly. She comes boldly, and that is what the blood of Jesus has done for us. It gives us access to come boldly to our Heavenly Father in the Holy of Holies. Verse 20, by a new and living way, which he had consecrated for us through the veil, that is to say his flesh, and having an high priest over the house of God. How beautiful that is. God has given us access into the Holy of Holies. And Hebrews 13 verse 20 says that, now the God of peace that brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, through the blood of the everlasting covenant. The blood of Jesus gives us access, and it gives us peace that passes all understanding, peace that passes all understanding, peace from our guilt, peace from our sins, peace from the shame that we once felt. The blood of Jesus is so powerful, and that is what gives us access. And And all of this you can get right from this book, The Blood of Jesus, The Blood Power. And to get this book, which is the number 12 in the Macarius 60, you need to place your order for the Macarius 60. If you haven't gotten it yet, it is not too late. You can still call the numbers that are scrolling on your screen, place your order, and get this treasure library of 60 books by my father, Bishop Dagiones. It will transform your life, your walk with God, give you a deep understanding of who you are, make your mandate clear, make the reason why God placed you here on earth known to you, and help you to fulfill it so that you can make earthly good. You can fulfill the mandate that God gave to you. The mandate is crystal clear as a result of gleaning through these books. That is why his mandate is clear. That is why he is fulfilling the purpose of which God created him. And your mandate can be clear too, so that you make it here on earth and get to heaven in God's style and sit on the throne forever, win medals, so that we can have dinner together in heaven at the tree of life, walk on streets of gold, enjoy the presence of our Heavenly Father forever. Call the numbers today. Do not procrastinate it. Do not procrastinate it. Do not. Do not. And guess what? The blood of Jesus gives us supernatural peace, like I said. Another supporting scripture is Colossians chapter 1, verse 19 to 20. I just read a small portion. It says that, "For it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell, and having made peace through the blood of Jesus," through the blood of his cross, "by him to reconcile all things unto himself," by him. Colossians 1:19-20. So through the blood of Jesus, God has given us peace, tranquility, quietness, tranquility. We come to a place of peace, serenity, because of the blood of Jesus. You can also feel the presence of God because of the blood of Jesus. Ephesians 2:12-16. It says that at that time you were without Christ, being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. But now in Christ Jesus, ye who sometimes were far off are made nigh by the blood of Christ. For he is our peace, who hath made both one and hath broken down the middle wall of partitioning between us, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, even the law of commandments contained in ordinances, for to make in himself of twain one new man, so making peace, and that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby. The blood of Jesus brings us close to God and helps us to feel God. It's broken down the partition, the wall that was separating us between God. Remember, as I said, that it's not that God's hand is too short that he cannot reach out to us, nor his ear blocked that he cannot hear us. But our sins have separated us between us and God. And the blood of Jesus removes that partition away. And another cool thing, through the blood of Jesus, we have communion with God and with other brethren, with other brothers and sisters in the Lord. Through the blood of Jesus, we have deep, intimate relationship with God. Deep communion. Communion means deep relationship. A relationship that involves the deepest parts That is why you can come before the throne of grace. You can come before the presence of God, and you do not have words to quantify the depth of pain you feel. But God, some way, somehow, knows and understands and heals us from the innermost part of our being. That is what the blood of Jesus gave us, communion with our Heavenly Father and with other brethren in Christ. 1 Corinthians 10:16 to 17. The cup of blessing which we bless, is it not the communion of the blood of Christ? The bread which we break, is it not the communion of the body of Christ? For we being many are one bread and one body, for we are all partakers of that one bread. Remember, Jesus is the bread of life. Bread of life, sent down from glory. Jesus is the bread of life. And when we partake in it, it brings us together. That is why we have communion. And on Monday, we shall partake in the communion. We have communion every Monday, right here on Quieter with Mrs. Monday. You know, the human body has different parts. The heart, the kidney, the liver, all the lungs, all of that, the muscles. Everything is connected as a result of the blood that circulates in our body. When a portion of our body does not have a good supply of blood, that part begins to die. The whole body is unified by the blood that is circulated. And the blood of Jesus, as it circulates through us, keeps us alive and helps us have a deep relationship with our Heavenly Father and with one another. Gone are the days when we did not give our lives to Christ. We were lonely. But when you give your life to Christ, the blood of Jesus brings you into a deep relationship that even transcends boundaries of natural blood relations. You get to have brothers and sisters that you did not know of, from all races, all backgrounds, all colors. And that powerful blood of Jesus gives us access to our Heavenly Father and access to have relationships with others from all walks of life. The blood of Jesus breaks down barriers. God loves you so deeply. That is why he sent his only son to die for you and I. Not that he had many sons and chose to send down only one. He sent his only son. And Jesus was not forced to come down to die for us. God the Father said that he wanted to save us. And he asked, who will I send and who will go? And Jesus said, here am I, send me. And he didn't give up when things got tough. And he was sent down here, he who was God, who was equal with God. He said, I and my Father are one. In the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. That's Jesus. Jesus is God. There are three that make up the Godhead: God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And in Genesis 1, when they were about to create us, the Spirit moved. And God consulted with the Son and the Holy Spirit that let us make man, let us make man in our own image. Our own image, meaning they were one. Our own image, the way we look like. Let us make man in our own image. So Jesus was God. And Philippians tells us that he did not think it robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of low repute, so he could die for you and I. He came to live amongst us. He became man. He became like the very thing or being that he created, just because of the magnitude of love that he had for you and I. And today I want to extend that love to you. If you want to give your life to Jesus, bow down your head with me and pray this prayer. Lord, I come before you and I ask forgiveness of my sins. I am sorry for the way I have lived. Forgive me and wash me and cleanse me with the precious blood that you shed for me on Calvary. I am most grateful. I believe you are the Son of God. I believe you came and died for me. And you went to hell, broke the chains of hell, and took the keys of hell. And you rose again. You are now seated at the right hand of God, making intercessions for me. I thank you and I give you praise. Holy Spirit, come and abide in me. Help me, lead me, guide me to be a child of God. In the name of Jesus. If you pray that prayer with me, you are born again. The blood of Jesus has wiped you clean, washed away all your sins. A new chapter has been opened in your life. Remember that our Heavenly Father does not count your sins and your iniquities anymore. You are clean. A brand new chapter has been opened in your life. Look for a Bible believing church, attend, submit under the pastor. Read the Bible, read this book, pray every day, and you will fulfill the mandate that God has placed upon your life, and you will make it to heaven. If you're feeling down and lonely this morning, I want you to know that God is still God. He loves you. He has not changed his mind about you. He is a merciful God. He's a loving God. Just call on him. What you are going through does not change who he is. In fact, it doesn't shock him. He knows it all. He knows the beginning of the matter, the end of the matter from the beginning. He says, I'm the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. He knows the details of our lives. We only see in part and we prophesy in part, but our Heavenly Father knows it all. He is not shocked. He is Almighty God, and that is our Father. Therefore, we can gain access to him, and the blood of Jesus has made that known. Get this book, read it, gather my powers so that you can get this book, read it, and have a deeper understanding of what Jesus did for us through his blood. And to teach on the subject, you can also get this one, Essential Charismatic Doctrines. This is part of the 11 textbooks that make up the Montana. The textbooks are powerful. You can use it to teach and get all these doctrines engraved in the minds and hearts of our children so that we can know who we are and walk in his precepts. God bless you all so very much for taking time out to join in this morning. We are out of time. We give God praise. I want you to subscribe to our podcast. It's Doug Hayward Mills. Doug Hayward Mills is our podcast. And Adelaide Hayward Mills is the other podcast. When you subscribe to the podcast, you have access to all of these powerful messages preached by my father and my spiritual man. The mandate is where he is because he listens to our father, Bishop Doug Yeomans, and to our mom, Lady Reverend Adelaide Hayward Mills, and he gleans in the books constantly. So subscribe and like our pages. This is one of our official pages, one of three. This Python with Mrs. Money. Like this page, like the other page is the Yeomans Literature Crusade. And Peter Bryce Senior hyphen the Monday, and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well, the Monday TV, so that you do not miss out on anything that the Monday posts. Iron sharpening iron. We encourage each other. So get connected today. I see right here, Reverend Pius Olanyo Akato. God bless you for joining in. Abigail Ankra, Pastor Eric AJ, Kia Betrain, Cara Bright, while my daughter's right there. God bless you all. Rita Sim, Doug Stokes, Sister Abigail, John Doug Michael, Lily Usu, Botina, Priscilla Tego, and many, many others. God bless you all so very much for taking time out to join in on today's quiet time. God bless you. Your mandate is crystal clear. I'll see you on Monday by the special grace of God. I want you to remember who you are. You are a daughter and a son of the Most High God. who created the whole world and everyone and every single thing in it. Therefore, you cannot, and I repeat, cannot be a victim of your circumstances. You are a victor. You are more than a conqueror. Have a blessed day and a glorious weekend in the mighty name of Jesus.